Oh, that's hot. That's hot.
Super Hot is a game of its own. You can't compare it to any prior game. It's a puzzle shooter, if I had to give it a definition. A John Wick simulator. In this game, you are put into action in 10 scenes. And when you stop, time goes in slow motion. And only when you move again, does the game move at a normal speed, leaving you room for some epic actions. And at the end, you can watch how epic this scene looked at a normal speed. The game looks minimalistic, but don't get fooled by that, because the game looks beautiful. Seeing how enemies shatter is always satisfying. Some call the game repetitive, because this is all you do, gun your way through different environments in the same mechanic. But while I agree that it is repetitive if you put it like that, I never felt the game to be repetitive. It's also short. You can finish it in around 4 hours. Some reviewers complain about it too. But I can't complain, neither about the length nor its repetitiveness. I feel that the game is well balanced and I liked it. And the game also has a DLC, My Control Delete, that adds more content and new gameplay mechanics. Like for example, here you get enemies that can be hit only one spot, or enemies with spikes that explode and affect other enemies. And Super Hot VR, even if it has the exact same gameplay mechanics, is a totally different experience in VR. The mechanics are the same, the game moves in slow motion, letting you think your next move, but there are some differences. Like for example, here you can move around. You can just look in different directions, duck, but not move around. Also, this game introduces later in the game a new mechanic. You can concentrate your power to crush your enemies' heads, if you are unarmed. And you can also crush bullets with pistols or swords. The story is different in the game, and the levels are also completely different to the other game. The levels are epic again, and seeing how good the 3D in headset is makes the game very immersive. The campaign is challenging. If it's easy at first, by the second half and the end of the game it becomes challenging, so that a game that would be half an hour long, if you were to finish it on first try every time, will take you around 3 to 4 hours to finish, or 9 minutes if you're a speedrunner. Anyway, the games are epic, and you should at least try them. They are unique, make you feel epic, and are incredible experiences, both of them.